Issues and Tissue, a contemporary magazine program that engages and discusses issues of development within and outside the state. The program brings to the fore ranging topics like education, politics, agriculture, just name it, while we examine the nitty-gritty of the issue in focus. Join me, BC Akpaida, 4:30 p.m. every Wednesday on African Independent Television, AIT, for an exciting time. Issues and Tissue. If we can think it, we can discuss it. All right, thank you very much for staying tuned on another lovely edition of Issues and Tissue, your developmental program that addresses issues of development in Edo State. And you know, we look at various topics ranging from agriculture to education to politics. And today we'll be looking at, we'll be meeting with the Honorable Commissioner for Agri and Natural Resources in Edo State, talking about Honorable Richard Uyi Edebiri, and he'll be taking us through the world of agri, actually through the agri sector in Edo State, and telling us all we need to know and how far, you know, they've gone, especially now that we'll be going into the elections. What has been the input of the governor, Governor Gordon Obaseki, in the agri sector? Let's hear him out, and don't go nowhere. Please stay tuned on your channel of choice.
My name is Richard Uyi Edebiri. I'm the Honorable Commissioner for Agriculture and Natural Resources, Edo State. The Edo State agricultural sector is one that has been developed by His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Edo State. Since time immemorial, he has been pushing for an agrarian economy, a more diversified economy that can see us actually living the era where we have overemphasize or over depend on oil. Since he came into power, we saw that it was kind of agriculture was seen differently. The people of Edo actually perceived agri as a venture, and that has been the regular way people saw agri. And seeing it as a venture in the sense that they just see agriculture as our old grand aged parents would see it hundreds of years back, where the subsistence kind of farming and all that, where people only just cultivate agriculture and just for food purpose, even though they are going to sell for just for a meager amount of money. But when we came into office, we thought it was nice that we changed the narrative, because if we are going to diversify the economy, it will be very, very important for agri to be seen as a business. That is the only way it will interest a lot of people to go into this sector. Now, in seeing it as a business, you have to put a lot of modalities, you have to put a lot of processes in place to ensure that it will interest people, because we also understand that the youths, they form an integral part of any society. So whatever you are doing, it's very important you carry them along. And if you want to carry the youth along in the agri sector, they are in for a quick wins. Now, what are we going to do differently? We thought it to be wise that we de-risk the agricultural sector. Now, in de-risking the agricultural sector, there are a lot of things you have to do. One of which we need to make our farmers get access to credit, because the only way people have been doing agriculture where they don't expand is because they don't have access to credit. Now, in doing that, we actually sought for a loan, and we got the loan, so it's helped us to actually give this loan to the farmers. We cluster them, put them together, check what they want to do, and by the time we know, we give them this loan. The loan is given to them in form of, the money is paid to their account, but there's a lien that's placed on it, and government give them all the input they need. These inputs are being sourced from the loan amount in their accounts. Doing all this will make people have interest in it. You don't have to go and look for your own money to see what to put into the sector. That is one. Another way is capacity building vis-a-vis research and development, because in agri today, the agriculture has evolved. You know, people have to do things differently. There are a lot of hybrid seeds that you can plant in short term. They start germinating, and for you to do all that, you have to be tutored by extension workers. So we also put a lot of emphasis there. That's why you see recently we are actually restructuring, and there's a rebate for the College of Agric. The essence for this is to train the desired manpower that will run on this sector. Because of the huge investment the state is going to put in agriculture, we also understand that we have to train for sustainability. And in training for sustainability, we have to have youths who will be well schooled, who will be well tutored to understand all the various processes in agric. We also understand that an issue of the past, we have post-harvest storage loss. That is why recently we've taken it upon ourselves to procure new silos, new dryer in different parts of the state, so that all these are farm, when they are harvested, when the farm produce are harvested, they can be stored so that these grains can be kept in their pristine form. Then also, we understand that we also have issues with infrastructure in our rural areas, because when you have a farm and you can't bring your goods out, again, it will not encourage you. So that's why as a state, we're also in the RAMP program, which is Rural Access to Agricultural Marketing Program. It's a World Bank intervention program that gives various states money to develop their rural roads. Any road that leads to any major farms is being developed. Markets in the rural area, that's the aim of this also, is to stem the rural urban migration. So we're working on that. But we're hoping that when we put all these things in place, if they are fully settled down, then the narrative would have been changed. But again, like I said, told you, and that was 3 years ago, but now the narrative is completely different. These are some of the things the government of the day is doing, and as we go further, I will enlighten you more on some other of our programs. The impact would have been devastating, but because we have a proactive government, and we have a very proactive governor, I will tell you that for me, our farmers during this era, they are smiling. In a bid to mitigate against the effects of COVID-19 during and post-COVID, Mr. Governor quickly came up with an initiative which is called the Independent Farmers Initiative. Now, we did this because we actually understand that during this period, a lot of the way we buy palliative, buy food in not too long a time, we may have issues with food shortage and all. So Mr. Governor sat with us and thought he wanted something different. He wanted to have a program whereby our farmers can be carried along, because 80% of the food that is being produced in Nigeria today is being produced by the smallholder farmers. So we wanted a program that we can bring them in, where they'll be part of it. They would understand the ideas Mr. Governor is trying to portray, and so that as soon as during the COVID and after it's gone, we'll have food sufficiency. Now, what this program is about is we assist independent farmers, provided you can guarantee that you have access to land and inputs. It's given to you the entire inputs, free, which range from the seeds, herbicide, fertilizers. They are all given to you for you to grow that farm. We have started that program. We did a launch recently for Edo South, Edo North, and Edo Central, and our farmers are very happy. They've been coming. We have a database where we source for our farmers, because we wanted to have genuine farmers, because it's not the time whereby you give money out to people who are not serious in farming and all that. So for me, the program is doing very well. Farmers have been coming, they've been getting their inputs, they've been planting, and we didn't just stop there. Because we understand, because of the investment, because of the huge amount we're going to procure this input for, we won't just leave it for the farmers to grow these farms and now start thinking of markets. So Mr. Governor went a step further to say, as a state, we'll see how we can primarily offtake these farmers that we have given this loan. So what we do is, as soon as their farms are ready, they should come to us. When they come to us, we go with them, see the farm. When it's harvested, we offtake them. Now, in offtaking them, you may want to wonder, oh, is government now going to start processing, doing all that? Even though we have that as a long-term plan, but for the immediate and short term, we are also working alongside with offtakers in the various commodity lines, and we've been speaking to a lot of them, and we just get them down. So we will just help out as a middle man in this process. So we get the farmers, then we just give it to the the off-takers, and from there they use it for their whatever they want to use it for. So these farmers, they don't have issues, they have to start thinking of how they would get all these products. Then again, we try to decentralize the storage points to see that for ease of distribution, we got warehouses in the three senatorial districts. We're also working with the local council chairman to see how best we can get all these things delivered to every local government. So even if you're a farmer in Sobe, you don't have to come down to Benin to come and pick your inputs. We'll just find a way, we'll give you the general location we have there, you pick it up from there. So I would say so far this COVID-19, our farmers are smiling, they have no cause to worry, and we're doing our best to see that we support them, we give them the encouragement, and they continue with their production. Which recently, even when COVID struck, we had issues. There was a huge fall in Brent crude and burning light fuel. So in fact, people have been calling for a diversified economy. If, like I said, the governor that we have been pushing for it from time immemorial. We're lucky because we have a proactive governor. So what we plan to do now is to have a commercialized agri sector. So what that means is we want to go a step further. Like the IFI, I told you, that's for like a short term. But for the long term, we want to see how government can actually start maximizing the benefits of agriculture. And one of the fastest ways to do that, which we are currently working in, is establishing special agro-processing zone. Because if you look along the value chain, when you do value addition in agriculture, you tend to make a lot of money off it. If you just stop only in the production line, you won't get all the benefit accrued to it. Now, in getting a processing zone, it will be an area where government will just develop the sector, the region, and they will take major infrastructure there like roads, lights, water, and all. Then various investors would be encouraged to go to that region, set up their plants, set up their companies, and see how they can offtake products. And like recently, not like today, I just visited Farmforth, their farm at Owolekpe, and I saw how they are doing massive work there. It's a potato farm, it's a 500 hectare farm, the potato farm, and they're also adding a poultry farm to it. The poultry is over 100,000 capacity. They're also putting a processing mill there that can take up to 1,500 to 2,500 beds every hour in terms of processing. So what I'm saying all this is, these are some of the encouragement these people are getting. So we are going to, obviously, even though oil prices bounce back in short, not too long a time, we're talking about tens of or hundreds of years, there will be no more oil dependency again. So that is why we're trying to put all these things in place. We're trying to pick various commodity, we'll complete the entire value chain here in Edo, and they'll be ready for exports. In turn, this will also bring revenue for the states. Now, aside that, one of the basic things, yes, I understand that government has no business in business because of sustainability, never can tell, but government is doing all everything is power to see that we create an enabling environment where businesses could thrive. Now, in creating an enabling environment, that is why we said we'll make sure our people have a zone where they will go and do their processing, process their food for onward transmission.
Issues and Tissue, a contemporary magazine program that engages and discusses issues of development within and outside the state. The program brings to the fore ranging topics like education, politics, agriculture, just name it, while we examine the nitty-gritty of the issue in focus. Join me, BC Akpaida, 4:30 p.m. every Wednesday on African Independent Television, AIT, for an exciting time. Issues and Tissue. If we can think it, we can discuss it.
We are trying to de-risk the sector. When you de-risk the sector, it would encourage a lot of youth to be encouraged to want to go into it. Now, recently, if you know, a lot of Libya returnees who came, is the governors gave marching order that they be clustered and put into one of the agric ventures, which we have just done. They are into fish farming production. They are in ADP there. They were very happy when they came. Everything was given to them, from fingerlings. We did everything for them. Now, that is just to produce. Government will still go and look for off-takers. Africa, then when we sell, the profit is theirs. So with that, a lot of youths are coming into it. And like I said, the youths, they form an integral part of any society. Whatever you are doing, they must be carried along. Because if you are not carried along, it's extremely difficult for you to get the best out of that process. Because tomorrow, they are the ones who will still be there and, okay, they want to follow what they have done. So we have a lot of plans in place. Even this, our IFI program, I have called on a lot of youths, their various body. I've told them to come to us. Let's see how we can put them into these programs where they can learn and know how to do any particular type of farming they will be interested in doing. And as soon as they are trained, they know what they are doing, we'll give them all the inputs and they start doing, they continue their production. So basically we have tried to see how we carry the youth along, and we are still doing a lot. And if you could see, I think I fall within that age bracket. So I have picked interest in farming, I've picked interest in agriculture. So I just want to encourage all of them to do the same. We have an office of the agripreneurship program and the ministry too. You can still come here. We have the ADP. These are three places you could walk up to. I'm very open. Anytime you come, if I'm available, I'll see you. But these are designated places that will sit and speak to anybody who is interested in all these programs. So if you go to the office of the office, which is stationed to look around, to work on this agripreneurship program, is in government, one office in government house. The Ministry of Agriculture is here also, then Edo ADP is there. So come to any of these places I've just mentioned and we'll see how we'll carry you along. Well, I'll tell you, it's been very high, and I've tried my best to be out there every day to inform our people, because I understand that if you don't know, you may never understand the processes we've been doing. In fact, when I go to TV houses and I speak, people tell me, oh, you guys are doing a lot, how come is you're not putting it out there? But so far so good. If you check the GDP that agri contributes to the state now, you see it's quite different before this administration came into office. So our scores very high. We've actually done a lot and we're still doing a lot. I don't even sit like you came here now waiting to see me. I've been on the field since. That is what I believe I should be doing. As the commissioner for agri, I shouldn't be in the office and just be signing papers and all that. I try to see how I can speak to investors, speak to farmers, see what is happening, people with giving grant, monitor them, see what they're doing to be sure it's actually what we want to do. But above all, I just want to encourage our people of Edo State, let them understand that we have a governor who means very well for the states. We have a lot of investors coming in. Asanita is coming in, Frankfurt is coming in, Pan Africa is coming in. Every day we have interface with them. They go to Edo North, they have interface to our farmers. We are still a work in progress. I have a background in project management, and for you to have a successful project, the three variants must be completed, which is cost, quality and time. And again, we have what is called the project life cycle that has to do from initiation, planning, execution and handing over. Nothing just starts to work from the day one. Yes, I hear people keep talking, oh, MOU government, but most time for successful projects, you will notice that more than 80% of the time is spent on planning, 20% execution. But if you turn the table around to do 80% execution, 20% planning, you will get it wrong. And the kind of government we have, we don't ever want to get it wrong. So that's why we spend a lot of time planning. And I'm very positive that in no too long a time, Edo people will see the effects of all we have been doing. Categorically, I'll say no. There's nothing of such. We don't have any age limit. In fact, farming is an occupation that cuts across all age sizes and, you know, what have you. So there's nothing like age barrier. So everybody's open to this.
All right, welcome back. This is Still Issues and Tissues on African Independent Television. I'm sure you've gained quite a lot from that interview with the Honorable Commissioner for Agri and Natural Resources here in Edo State. And he has been talking about mechanized farming and the reason why you and I need to go back to the farm, especially post-COVID, so that we can get food to eat. But of course, who told you Agri can't pay your bills? Yes, you heard the Honorable Commissioner say a lot about agriculture and how well we can all make it through agriculture. And what the government is also doing, you know, in promoting agriculture and encouraging more farmers and more farming in Edo State. Of course, even with the grant and all that, please take advantage of it. That's why we bring all of these segments to you, and we bring all of those personalities to tell you more about what is happening here in Edo State. So stay tuned on the program next week. We'll be bringing you another exciting edition of Issues and Tissues, and of course, something you don't want to miss. My name is BC Akwaida. Have a lovely day.
Issues and Tissue, a contemporary magazine program that engages and discusses issues of development within and outside the state. The program brings to the fore ranging topics like education, politics, agriculture, just name it, while we examine the nitty-gritty of the issue in focus. Join me, BC Akpaida, 4:30 p.m. every Wednesday on African Independent Television, AIT, for an exciting time. Issues and Tissue. If we can think it, we can discuss it.